So the question would be, is this more difficult than last chapter? I don't know. I think when we ask if we understand this content, what is it? What should you do when you don't understand this? Okay, so if that's the case, I'm going to say that you did not understand last chapter, and if that is the case, how many of you, you don't have to ask myself for extra help, but how many of you actually did? You could say everybody did. I don't know. Did you? Okay. So everything in this chapter, it really has no relation to what we've done prior to this, because with organic compounds, it is mainly about one element and one element only. Yes, there's other types of elements that are associated with this, but mainly the element that has to do with carbon. Okay? Okay. Now, if you choose to write this content down, because it helps me explain this to you. Okay.
I don't think I was given the same vocab.
You got yesterday hands.
Oh yeah, I did. It's behind all my papers.
Okay. The reason this has nothing, well, I wouldn't say nothing to do, but for the most part, organic compounds, okay, most compounds contain the element carbon. Sometimes it's just carbon and hydrogen only. That's what we spend a lot of time on in this class. But 90% of millions of carbon compounds are known as organic, okay? That means, again, the majority of it is carbon and hydrogen, and the rest are inorganic. And that's what we wrapped up with, where you have sodium chloride, phosphoric acid, maybe potassium sulfate, potassium nitrate, this activity that we did together in class and made specific calculations for that. That is inorganic chemistry. Okay? When we talk about organic now, okay, this is a periodical that you could be used just like Flynn Scientific to order compounds. It's called Aldrich, which is a just says Handbook of Fine Chemicals. Okay, so I'll just open up to pass the index, and it's got page 2,672. Nice. Okay, so what's the print like in this book?
Really small.
So these are all organic compounds that do not repeat themselves.
All?
Okay.
That's a lot. Do we have to like all of them?
That would not be possible.
Unless you have photogenic.
Okay.
I'm going to memorize that book. You won't.
So again, I hope that we can appreciate this. There's other aspects in nature that, for instance, there's no way we're going to be able to comprehend everything that's available and or to classify, for instance. Insects would be a zoological term, that there are so many insects on this planet that probably only